Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
Hi, today's salutations come from Chennai, the MMRT racetrack to be precise, where I'm riding the 2020 edition of the RR310. Now, when we got the invite for this motorcycle ride for the first time, I thought, how different can a BS6 upgrade be? As it turns out, quite a lot. So what all is new? Well, it gets a new 5-inch TFT color instrument cluster. It gets 4 ride modes. It gets new tires, which I like really much, but we'll get to that later. It has a new color scheme with a black, gray, and a hint of red combination, which looks rather very nice. And of course, it is BS6 compliant.
The RR310 continues to be one hell of a looker and has that super sport character. It gets split LED projector headlamps, an LED for the tail lamp as well, and a fully digital instrument cluster, the controls for which are on the handlebar. This means the switch gear has been updated, and to say the least, the build and finish is rather good on the buttons. In fact, the fit and finish is commendable all over.
So it is pretty much like a smartphone at the front of your motorcycle, and it is immensely informative. Well, because now it has a lot more to display on it. Starting with the ride modes that I mentioned before, it gets urban, rain, sport and track. So what do these ride modes do exactly? When you pick urban, rain, sport and track, the system changes the throttle mapping and the ABS settings. For example, if you're going to be in sport or track, the ABS will have less intervention compared to when you do in urban or rain. So you want to use the urban mode for your everyday rides. You want to use the rain mode for when it's raining. You want to use the sport mode for some spirited riding, maybe you're going through up the mountain twisties, and the track mode, well, for when you're on a racetrack. Well, nobody said that you can't use that on a street, and I know that you will. Another new feature is the glide-through mode. Now, this is meant to reduce fatigue during bumper-to-bumper traffic. So what this does is you can simply let go of the clutch and the motorcycle will move forwards at very low speeds, and you don't have to throttle it. You don't have to use the throttle, so well, your right hand can feel a little relaxed.
It needs to be noted that the sport and track mode will not be activated until the bike has been run in, which means you can have the taps opened after about 1,000 kilometers during the first service. The difference between urban rain and sport track modes is, of course, easy to spot. The latter two have more power and the throttle response is nippy and more aggressive. Besides, the rain and urban modes have full ABS intervention. I think what I'm trying to say here is that the ride modes don't just change the color theme on the instrument cluster. You can actually pick one that suits your current ride conditions the best.
Now the power figures. It makes about 34 horsepower in track and sport mode, which is reduced to 25 in urban and rain. 0 to 60 time is under 3 seconds and the top speed remains 160 kilometers an hour. I must talk about my ride experience on the MMRT today. We had the chance to use all 4 ride modes. Well, obviously we did not really use the urban and rain very much, but the sport and track mode, well, the contrast in how the throttle responds and how much ABS intervention there is quite substantial when you change the modes, and you will definitely experience it once you're on the street. And what made the ride better was that it now uses Michelin Road 5 tires, which have plenty of grip, and leaning into corners and staying into those leans was quite a lot of fun and quite confidence instilling as well. I know you're wondering what changes has the BS6 transition made. The one thing that I have to say here is that the engine feels a lot more refined than it did before. Now the RR310 had some complaints about vibrations, but now it's quite smooth. The engine is pretty smooth. There are not many complaints about vibrations, although some creep in after 6,000 RPM, but it's not really a complaint. Another change that this refinement has brought along is that the gear shifts are super smooth now. It's now a gentle click.
The RR310 has already been equipped with TVS's race-tuned slip and assist clutch. Like I said previously in a video sometime in June last year, that the downshifts on RR310 were now more civilized, the 2020 edition feels even more refined. Having said that though, there is still sufficient engine braking. Being out on the racetrack on the 2020 RR310 felt more confidence instilling as it did on the previous version, since I could maintain bigger speeds on corners. One reason are the new dual compound tires, which in very simple words means that they have tougher material in the middle section for longevity, and softer rubber on the sides for better grip during leaning. The treads on the Road 5 tires could also suggest a good performance on wet road conditions. The other reason is that the RR310 is swift to change directions, very easy in fact to maneuver. The suspension setup and the brakes remain the same, however the rider now has the choice to pick how much ABS intervention they want. The RR310 is simply everything you've known it as and a bit more. It has been liked by those who like touring or simply have been wanting a great looking motorcycle, but now it definitely, surely, clearly packs better performance than it did before. Now it suits your requirement if you wish to learn knee downs and also keep a closer eye on your rides, which is now possible through smartphone connectivity.
The RR310 has garnered a lot of popularity among young riders ever since we first saw it as a concept, which was called the Akula. We've seen iterations of this motorcycle over the years, with the 2020 edition being the best version of it. Sure, the price has gone slightly higher, however, so has the performance. Until next time, thank you very much for watching.